Hey friends, it's Lisa. Welcome and thank you for watching another one of my videos. So today, right now, when I am filming this video, it is the last day of 2020. I don't think collectively as a society, we have come together and have all, I believe, wanted this year to be over. And so this day is just like a breath of fresh air, or maybe that will be tomorrow. But anyway, we're here and I'm here with my dog, Milo, who you may hear walking around. You know, he's my co-host, my silent co-host. But anyway, happy New Year's Eve. I know this is a lot of rambling. I'm just excited, honestly. I can't wait. But anyway, today I have my candle empties video for December of 2020. So I have not bought a single candle all year. This has been a unintentional no-buy, but I really wanted to focus on using the candles that I already had in my collection, or if someone gifted me a candle, that would be the exception. And that's what I have today. I have one candle that I had already in my collection, and then I was gifted an early Christmas present. The first candle I have is from Bath & Body Works. And if you know me, if you watch my candle videos, you know I have a feeling about BB Dubs. And I should say a rule. And my rule is I do not buy 3-wick candles. But in the past, I have bought their 1-wicks. And I have a 1-wick of Vanilla Bean Noel. And this was in the green wax with the little Christmas scene on the label. This is a 7-ounce candle. And I mean, Vanilla Bean Noel is one of their quintessential Christmas holiday scents. It comes out every year, they repackage it, but they call it what it is. It's the same scent and they just put a new Christmas scene on it and there you go. So the scent notes given by BB Dubs, which can always be iffy because they can say whatever they want and then it doesn't make sense. But they say this is vanilla bean, marshmallow fluff, and vanilla cake with essential oils. And this candle was nice, but it was too sweet for me. And I don't know if it's because I've kind of taken a step back in 2020 from burning candles, or maybe, I don't wanna say as I get older, but as I get older, maybe my scent preferences are changing. But I felt like this was too sweet some of the time. And I would start it, I'd have it burning, and then I would have to extinguish it because I could not take how sweet it was. So it took me a while actually throughout the month to get through this because as I said, I would like have it burning, it would start to pull and I'd have to extinguish it because it was just becoming headache inducing. Do I think it's a bad scent? Absolutely not. And I do think that the 1-wick of the BB Dubs candle is far superior than the 3-wicks. Don't waste your money on those. Those are garbage. But I don't know in the future if I would buy this scent again because as I said, I was having a lot of trouble getting through this. It just gave me a headache and I wasn't having it. But it is a quintessential holiday scent available at BB Dubs. I would put money on it that you could get it next year if you don't have it already, or they're at their semi-annual sale, you could probably pick these up. But this one, in particular with this style label, I would say probably 2018, maybe 2017, I'm not really sure. But yeah, you can get this every year. This next candle was an early Christmas present from my father. And it was a Yankee candle because like myself, my dad is a fanboy. I'm a fangirl, he's a fanboy, but you get the picture. We're both really into our Yankee candle scents. And so he had gotten me an early Christmas present. He had gotten me 2 of the cracked glass Christmas poinsettia votive holders, which were really cute. And he had 2 of the large jar candles wrapped in the tissue paper. And he said, you get one of them, you could do however you want. You could surprise yourself, pick one, and that's the one. Or if you want to open both and choose your scents. And so that's what I ended up doing. I unwrapped the paper to see which 2 scents he chose, and I was going to choose one of them. So the first one he picked was sugar cookie, or I think it was like vanilla cupcake or something like that. I think it was vanilla cupcake. And or Christmas cookie. I take it all back. It was Christmas cookie. I smelled it and I was like, oh, okay. It was nice, but going along with vanilla bean Noel, I think just those cookie, sugary scents, right now in the place that I'm in my life, I can't handle those scents. They give me headaches. And so I looked at the second candle that he had, and it was this one. It is mistletoe. And this was in the large jar. And I'm happy I got this one because, as you can see, I have an artificial tree and I need something to help give me that sense of a real tree. I need that beautiful, beautiful scent of tree to get me through the Christmas season. And mistletoe, even though it wasn't Christmas tree or, you know, leaf or anything like that, it definitely delivered. So I went ahead and I went on Yankee's website so I could get you the notes, because to me, this just smells like amazing, beautiful Christmas tree. But Yankee's a little more specific than that. So they say the woody scents of mistletoe, berries, pine boughs, and holly create this holiday tradition. And in fact, this candle is already on clearance on the yankeecandle.com website. But the fragrance notes are a top note of green aromatic, a mid notes of fresh pine needle and bark, and base notes of sweet clove and spice. So, yeah. I mean, I wouldn't know this is mistletoe, but I would know that it's beautiful Christmas tree. And I love it. So, as you can see, there was definitely some sooting on this, which, user error, but I feel like I got most of it. The adhesive on the wick came undone, and so that's when I call a candle. I don't burn it anymore after that, just because it becomes a fire hazard and it's unsafe. A viewer, thank you so much for your recommendation, told me that I should buy a hot plate. That way I can warm the rest of the wax and get the scent out of it. And I do have a candle crock. I just don't know where it is. But I will take your suggestion of going to, I think it was the Dollar Tree or something like that, and finding one. So that way I could get a little more mileage out of this wax. So thank you so much for that suggestion. I really, really enjoyed this candle, like I said, because of my Christmas tree, and just, it helped me really embrace the season coming in to my house, or I should just say being in the same room, because I didn't really come in and out because it's COVID. I was pretty much in, but having the scent of the mistletoe candle was really, really nice and helped, you know, give me that sense of Christmas in areas where I might have been missing it. So as I said earlier in the video, I have unintentionally not bought a candle all of 2020. And at first I joked for a while that maybe some of the things that were going on in the world was because I didn't buy a candle. And if I just bought a candle, then maybe things would change for the better, but I didn't, because that's silly. But what have I learned? First of all, I walked into a store the other day and I saw a candle that really smelled nice. And I really kind of want this candle, but then I was like, you're only like less than a week away. You got this, girl, you got this. It's like when I told myself I'm gonna give up soda, and then now I'm like 12 or 13 years later, like, it's just like walking away from it. So I realized I don't need candles. Like, before I felt like I needed a candle to breathe, needed a candle to live. I realize now that is so not true. I also realized that I still have a crap load of candles. Do I know definitively what a crap load is? Absolutely not. But I know that I have a lot. And when you have a candle like this that says, ooh, it can burn for up to 110 hours, that's one candle. That's a lot of hours when you start looking at, like, the 15 or the 20 or the 30 large jars that you have in your collection, not to mention any of the Bath and Body Works candles or random third party candles that you have, or wax tarts or Scentsy clamshells. It's a lot of wax. And I feel like that's a lot of wax for like what I'm doing in my life. Like, I don't think I have that much time. You would think that you're staying at home, like, yeah, burn candles, heck yeah. But I realized, especially this year, sometimes it's just nice to not burn a candle, which I know would be like sacrilege, like on a, like in a candle community, but sometimes it's just nice to just smell the air and not smell fragrance. And I really enjoyed that in 2020 because of the fact that I was home so much. It really made me realize that sometimes when I'm burning candles consistently, it does give me headaches, and it does, you know, kind of like diminish how special they are, like instead of just like burning it when I really want to. So I guess I'm trying to wrap up this ramble by saying that I'm going to buy a candle in 2021. I don't think I'm going to continue this no buy, but I do think I'm going to be more intentional about the candles that I bring home. You know, before it was kind of just like, there is a deal, let me get the deal, 4 for $44. But now it's more, I want to be intentional, and I want my purchase to mean something to me, and I want the candle to mean something, or I want that scent to be special. It's not just going to be, I'm buying it because I'm buying it. This wasn't what I set out for, but it's the lesson I learned in 2020. So thank you for coming to my TED talk about my candles. I hope you'd enjoyed it. So anyway, guys, that was it. Those were the two candles that I burned in December. Not a lot, but you know what? It was enough. And my new Christmas light just turned off. So when I'm editing this, I don't know where I was in what I was saying because my new light just died. But I put a new light bulb in and we're good. So anyway, that was my video. If you liked it or found any information helpful, please think about giving this video a thumbs up and subscribing. And until next time, guys, I hope you all have a happy new year, a way better 2021, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.